Hello, Scrappers. Today I will check what is inside these cameras. I removed the screws and now I will speed up a little and disassemble them. After that, we'll check together what is inside. Is there something precious that worth scrapping them? Okay, let's speed up the scrapping now. Okay guys, I'm back. Let's check what we have. Let's start with the metal. Nice piece of aluminum, iron, aluminum, 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 same here, iron, and another piece of iron. So these cameras are made most of aluminum, which is good. They're supposed to be white, so this is one of the reasons. Let's check the other parts. Same story here. Probably this is stainless, I'll check it. Could be also aluminum. And all these lids. So, what we get first? First, we get some nice amount of aluminum from these cameras. Let me move it aside. And a little iron. There's some wires, almost nothing, let's say. And let's go to the interesting part. What else we got here? From the first one, we have two small boards. This one looks more or less like a power board. There is a big transistor, there are some capacitors, and actually I don't even see MLCCs on it, so this looks like a small power board with a couple of switches, etc. Usually this is the interesting thing in the cameras. I'm not sure if you can see, but here we have small ICs, which are not that interesting. For the crystals and crystal oscillators, I just collect them, so I'll keep this here. And the most important is here, usually the sensor, here you have gold plating, really good gold plating around the sensor. So this is what really has value in these cameras, the sensor, the only place where you can find some decent amount of gold. Let's look at the second one. Same story here. This is the sensor of the camera. And here I see gold plating, really thick and good gold plating, some ICs. On the other side, quite big MLCCs, and these look good quality ones. Tantalum capacitors also. So this is a good small board. There's a lot of value on this 5 gram board, let's say. The other one is with from the second camera, has also really good MLCCs, some tantalums, two-sided chip, probably some kind of memory. And this huge, for the size of the camera and the board, IC, four-sided, good gold content inside, I can say. Again, a small board with almost nothing, more or less it looks like a power board. So, few things to take from here. Two capacitors, two, three capacitors, a small IC, almost nothing. But the interesting one is the third one. Look at the size of these boards. So honestly, I have never scrapped such a camera like the third Panasonic one. It's so old. I will definitely check these capacitors. I don't expect they to have palladium, to be honest. Probably these are simple capacitors. I mean, for these are tantalums probably. These that look like a drop. For the rest of the capacitors, I can say that probability is really, really low to have palladium in some of them, but I will definitely check them. Probably some silver can be found in these old ones. So more or less nothing really, really impressive. I see one transistor here, old one. I'll try to break it. And when you break it, you see it's not like the Russian ones. This one contains copper. It's a nice copper transistor, let's say it in this way. In many Russians, there is gold inside. So more or less, probably there is some silver in this switch, but nothing really amazing or impressive on these boards. Same story is here. Two ICs, probably nothing in them. These brown capacitors, I will definitely check if they contain some palladium, some old transistors, and nothing really interesting or impressive. The interesting was the technology, because this was really old camera. And look at the sensor. Compare it with the new ones. CCTV, the new style, with the old, this is the old CCTV, before the digital era, before the sensor gets like a half centimeter by half centimeter. So this here says Matsushita, made in Japan. So, and this tube looks intact. So I'll keep this tube in my collection. You see this here. So this is really interesting sensor. Even if there is any amount, if you know, please write in the comments if you know if there is decent amount of gold or other precious metals in these sensors, but it looks amazing. Look at the technology, how it changed. The new one and the old one. This is the sensor of the camera. And this is relatively old, but modern camera with the sensor. So, and of course, if you have vacuum tube, you need to control the electrons in this vacuum tube. So you look at this, there is a lot of copper here. It's really heavy. And also there was a big transformer. It's also really heavy, really nice small transformer, but really heavy. For the size of the camera, to put this size of transformer, it looks in 21st century, it looks strange. Probably in 1990 was the best you can buy. But this transformer adds some value. And here we have some copper. So I will also give this to systems of lenses, because this one is complex. So you have two lenses and it looks really, really sophisticated. To a friend of mine that is he's a photographer, he's doing some projects, so maybe he will find a way to use this, to give them second life, let's say. But the most impressive is this sensor. I've never seen such a thing. And we have these three connectors. Nothing impressive with them. So guys, thanks for watching and keep scrapping. You can find such interesting things in the old stuff. Bye.